So I would say, if I were an atheist, your question, if I were an atheist and the evidence for the resurrection was presented to me, I should at least be open-minded to consider it and allow the data to challenge my worldview. A responsible person does that, no matter which side they're on. They allow the data to challenge their worldview.
All right, Leia. So she's considered the evidence. She's a committed atheist. You make this argument to her. We are justified in believing. And she says, look, I've got a pretty well-established belief that supernatural stuff just doesn't exist. So even though it sounds ad hoc to suggest that it's an alien thing or a twin brother, or, I mean, maybe you just don't hang out with enough magicians, but there's some very strange-looking things happen on stages all the time, and we think, well, that actually didn't really happen, but it sure sort of looked like it happened. Do you think that the evidence for the resurrection is strong enough that it could take someone like that from, say, committed atheism to a little more agnostic or all the way to theism, or do we kind of have to already be open to the supernatural world before an argument like this is really going to take hold?
Yeah, that is a great question. Well, I think that we always, no matter whether we're a believer in whatever religion or an atheist or an agnostic, we should always be open to look at data, because we have to be open-minded to let the data, like I said in my opening statement, let the data speak for themselves apart from prejudgments, because someone's wrong, right? I mean, Larry and I both can't be right here. One of us is wrong.
Or both. But.
Or we both could. Well, there's no in-between ground. Either Jesus was raised or he wasn't. So one of us is wrong here.
That should work.
So, well, I wasn't talking about whether he was raised, but whether we're justified in believing he was raised.
Okay, but I know, but you don't believe Jesus was raised, but...
Probably not.
Okay, so...
I'm going to say no.
Well, all right. Well, not everybody can be right, though, or correct.
Right.
If we just say not just you and I, but everybody in here. Atheism and theism cannot both be true. And so someone is wrong. And whoever it is, whether it's someone like myself, which I don't think I'm wrong, but I could be. No one's 100%. You know, we can't be. So... I think we all should be open-minded. And so I would say, if I were an atheist, your question, if I were an atheist and the evidence for the resurrection was presented to me, I should at least be open-minded to consider it and allow the data to challenge my worldview. A responsible person does that, no matter which side they're on. They allow the data to challenge their worldview.